All right, well, it's 8 o'clock. I want us to go ahead and start on time, and then hopefully we'll finish early. We've got several posted agendas which we need to call roll for, so bear with us and we'll go ahead and call all the rolls.
Council, Miller.
Here.
Eckhart. Benson. Melton. Valencia.
Here.
Fisher.
Here.
Stelling.
Here.
Hannaford.
Here.
And there's a quorum of the City Council.
Airport Commission. Kinsey. Turner. Miller.
Here.
Logsdon. Washburn.
There's not a quorum for the airport.
Board of Adjustment. Turner. Reed. Miller.
Here.
Barton. Simon.
There's not a quorum for the Board of Adjustments.
Cemetery Board. Martin.
Here.
Clark. Barton.
There is not a quorum for the cemetery board.
Library board. Joseph. Reed. Wilt. Valencia.
Here.
There's not a quorum.
Karavik.
Oh, there's more big.
Oh, okay, sorry. Klein. Okay.
There's not a quorum for the library board.
Planning Commission. Corneli. Hamilton. Schultz. Hebert. Colerus. Miller.
Here.
There's not a quorum for the Planning Commission.
Recreation Complex Board. Spellman. Glass. Hanson. Fisher.
Here.
Smith. Stratton. Ely.
There's not a quorum for the Recreation Complex Board.
Tourism Tax Commission. Janet Valencia. Tucker. Parsons. Bickerstaff. Ritter.
There's not a quorum for tourism. That's all. Okay. Well, thank you all that are here. This is a first for our community. I'm excited to be able to do this for the City of Alva and to, as we, you know, I'll introduce our facilitator here in a second, but I do want to thank all of you for being here. We would like to accomplish quite a bit today. We've got a long day, but hopefully not too long. You know, if things go well, we may get out of here early, so that would be all right as well. We thought since this was our first time, it would be a good idea to have someone come in and help facilitate our discussions. We've contacted and we're recommended to contact Steve Cleaver. He's the Business and Industry Director at Northwest Tech in Fairview. He is responsible for doing a lot of things. If you've worked with Charlotte Hadwiger out here at the Alva campus, they have their counterparts in their roles. He's a 1968 graduate of Fairview High School. He has his bachelor's in sociology and a minor in psychology from Southwestern. He is leadership trained and has certifications including Worldwide Training Organizations Achieve Global and Development Dimensions International. He also holds certifications from the Center for Rural Entrepreneurship, Learn Market Institute, Six Sigma Champion, Denison Qualifying Training, and he's an OSHA 501 General Industry Safety Outreach Trainer. He's a member of the Major County Economic Development, Fairview Lions Club, and is a president of the Fairview Chamber of Commerce. He's a former board member of the Red Carpet Country, and I notice on his wall in his office, he's also a former recipient of Fairview Citizen of the Year Award. So. He's very involved in his community and very helpful with other places. His career before Northwest Technology Center was with Walden Inc., a manufacturing plant there in Fairview, and his experiences there included very, very welding, truck driving, assembly, purchasing agent, human relations, and ultimately the director of operations in charge of all manufacturing. I think based on the conversation that Joe Don and I had with Steve yesterday, we're going to have a production day. And at that, I'm going to turn it over to Steve to have him, I guess, get us going.
All right.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Go ahead. Again, appreciate the opportunity here on a Saturday. And you're all here by choice, right?
Yeah. Sure.
Okay. What's going to happen today is really up to you, because this is your meeting. And what I'm going to invite you to do is be very participant in the opportunities that you have here today to look at strategies and objectives and goals for your next fiscal year, which I believe starts in July of 2016, rolls into the end of June in 2017. So you, as a representatives here of the city of Alva, have this opportunity to be involved. And we at Northwest Tech right now are in the process of doing strategic planning for a lot of objectives and goals that we have for the next 3 to 5 years. So that's a process that we are always under, is looking at how we can do things better and actually as a continuous process improvement. So today, what we're going to do is through several of these specific targets that we have for discussion, we'll divide into groups and we'll have discussion, and through those groups, we're going to develop certain goals and objectives within the corporate plan for the city of Alva. So, which is definitely going to help drive the budget for next year. You know, if you don't have a plan, you're going to definitely hit it every time. So if you shoot for a goal and you don't have a plan, you'll definitely hit it. So we want to have a plan so we can, you know, maybe hit some goals and objectives that would benefit the city of Alva. So, what I'm going to invite you to do today is fully participate in these discussions and demonstrate respect through, you know, through our discussion. We're going to consider everybody's opinions, and we want to be courteous in this format. We want to be respectful of your time. We started on time, and when it's 5 o'clock, whether we're done or not, we're done. If we can get out sooner, that'd be fantastic. So we're gonna keep things moving. We're gonna stay on task, and when we have a break time, and we say 10 minutes, we're gonna get started in 10 minutes, whether you're here or not. So I invite you to, you know, take care of business, go take care of the cell phone calls, you know, do your discussion, but we're gonna be on task. Whether you perceive yourself as a leader of the city of Fairview,
or
Alva, goodness gracious, sorry, Alva. people in the community see you as a leader. So your behavior out of these walls and wherever you're at, you are a leader within the realm of responsibility that you have, whether you're an employee, whether you're a city council member, whether you're a supervisor, whether you're on all these boards and commissions that you mentioned earlier, people see you as a leader in this community. So your behavior outside of the walls that you have, whether it's out in the community, out on the street, at a Alva basketball game, your behavior exemplifies the city of Alva and the community which you serve. Just like me, I'm Mr. Northwest Tech in a lot of places because that's where I work. I'm also part of the chamber this year, and my behavior in the community is very important. And so I invite you in this format, behave in a very respectful way, and we can get a lot done today. if we move. So, again, something that I've learned over the years, and I've not been probably the best example, but I've learned some things over the years, is when I worked at Waldon, and I worked there for about 28 years, I was went through a lot of leadership, had to report to a lot of different bosses. And through that, I can always say I wasn't always respectful. I didn't always agree and didn't feel like I was treated appropriately. I did have a boss or two that I really respected. And how you talk and how you show respect to your leadership is very important. And I do a lot of leadership classes for high schoolers, juniors and seniors in high school, and also our tech center. And I've done a program called Leaders of Character, the West Point Way. And we talk about ethics. Can people trust what you do and say? That's pretty important. Can people trust what you do and say? Do you communicate in a way that shows respect? And do you give respect? Do you communicate in such a way that your voice, your tone of voice, your body language is appropriate? 58% of our body language is considered by experts the major way we communicate. So how you shake somebody's hand is very important. I was 26 years old. My dad is in a hospital bed after major surgery, and I go shake his hand like this, like a limp, wet noodle. And he said, "Son, when you shake somebody's hand, you grip it firmly and you look in their eyes." That body language is crucial to your communication style. So I've taught my four children that posturing and have had some remarkable feedback from that. Even as a young child, I've had adults say, "Boy, your son knows how to communicate with his body language. I appreciate that." So, you as leaders in the community, your body language is crucial how you communicate. Just a little side note. So I invite you to really take that to heart, even today. So, we want to today demonstrate honesty and integrity in what we do, because we've got a lot of ground to cover in our objectives, and you've got the the format and the agenda in front of you. So with that being said, I'm going to turn this over to Joe Don. He's going to go over some reports that he's going to talk about and set the groundwork kind of for what you've already done. And then we'll jump right into discussion on economic development. Again, we're going to divide into groups, and we'll get this thing going.
Well, first of all, thank everybody for being here. I know it's not what we planned to do today on Saturday if we would have had our others. First thing I kind of wanted to talk a little bit about was the stabilities test that we did. I know the council did talk about it to some degree when we did it at the training. And if we look at the combined training, the combined scores that were just on our employees, well, from everybody and combined them all together, we, for everything except meetings and employees, we were a 6. About midway, 1 through 10, we were a 6. On the meetings and employees, we were a 7. So, how are we going? One of the things I would look at it this is, if we do this again next year, how do we do? What do we do to make it better? Some of the things that I've come up with, that would be my commitment to help make things better, would be think big but act small. We need to take care of the small, we need to do the small things very well. We need to remember that people don't remember days, they remember moments. And when it comes down to it, they'll forget what we did, they'll forget what we said, but they won't forget the way we made them feel. You know, I think if we start off by doing these and focusing on some of these areas a little bit at a time, we can improve those scores, which I think helps improve our communication as a whole to the community. One of the reasons I say that, we just polled the people that work for us, and they thought we're okay. Why would we want to thank the other 4,000 or 5,000 people in the community think anything better of us? I think we're better than okay. How do we get that across? Some of the things that we have done over the recent years that I think we've done well. We've implemented a new format for municipal accounting and budgeting. We've gone from what was referred to as the Estimate of Needs to the Municipal Budget Act. Estimate of Needs was a very limiting way to budget. Municipal Budget Act allows a lot more flexibility. We've implemented a council board member training manual and program. And we have said that all new board members, all our current board members and councilmen will go through this training. And all new members will go through this training as they come on. And we will be updated every year. We are in the final stages of developing a master plan for the rec center. I think we finally got a drawing that we are happy with, that the rec center is happy with. We just need to put timelines to it. We have developed and have on file maps for both our water and our sewer lines to help better locate those lines and fix the issues that come up. We have undertaking a very large annexation project. At different times, we've annexed around hotels. We've annexed south of Share Drive. Then we extended that annexation to include the airport and the rec center. We have annexed some housing addition east of Myers Drive. And we've annexed some property east of town all the way out to our industrial park. Over the past 3 years, in land mass wise, we've probably doubled the size of Alva. Some of the projects that we've worked on, we've completed our sanitation transfer station. The original bid cost on that project was $1.205 to $1.207 million. We've been able to get it done for $592,000. We're in the final stages of installing our automatic meter reading program. The anticipated cost for that was $800,000. We have gotten it done for $625,000. We've got our Young Street project that's replacing a major water line through town as a delivery system. Anticipated cost on that project was $521,000. We've gotten it done for $323,000. We constructed water lines to, sewer lines to Atwoods. Cost us $221,000. Did that as economic development. We've implemented new ordinances for both purchasing and fund stabilization to ensure that we have funds to operate in future years, and that we have a, as far as the purchasing program, we've got a set method to, and guidelines, and written guidelines on what we what now we should be purchasing things. We are undergoing utility bill evaluations. Currently, we've reworked the OG&E bill and got with OG&E, and we'll be saving about $2,900. We're currently saving about $2,931 a month because we've reworked those bills. We are currently looking at our AT&T bill. The potential savings on that is $4,166 per month. That's $50,000 a year is the potential savings just on the AT&T bill. Those are some of the highlights, I think, of what we've done over the past few years. Now, we hear a lot in the news about sales tax being 30% down. Yes, it is. But our cash levels, our cash in the bank, are only down about 4% from 2014. So we're running about the same cash level as we were in 2014. Our investments from 2015 have grown by 14%. So we've increased our investments. Yes, our sales tax is down. If we look at just last year, which was a huge year for us, we are 22% down. We expected to be 15% down. From 2014, we're about $500,000 down. So we're running about at the same level we were in 2014. So as far as our sales tax, which is a major revenue source for us, we're not, it's not as bad as the picture paints. If we look at that by our population, in 2014, it's estimated Alva had a population of 5,174. So it would be about $80 a person. If we look at as far as our sales tax collections, if we look at our population with a 15-minute drive radius, we're looking at about $58 a person is where we're at. Last year, 2015, we were at $103 a person, or within the 15-mile radius, $74 a person per month. Our utility bills is another major revenue source. Currently, we're running about $1.6 million. In 2015, we were at 1.7. In 2014, we were at 1.6. We are about 2% down in our utility revenues right now from where we were at in 2014. We're running about the same amount of households. That's the households that we service, about 2,568. 2016, that's $89.57 per month per household. $98.32 in 2015 per month per household. As far as our revenues are concerned, in 2014 we had $14 million in revenues. 2015, we had 17 million. This year, we budgeted 15 million. Currently, we're running about 10 million in revenues. Estimated by the end of the year, we'll be at 15 million. That's about 6% less than what we budgeted. It's about 11% less than where we were at last year. And about 6% more than what we were at in 2014. As far as our expenditures go, in 2014, we were at 12 million. 2015, we're at 15 million. We budgeted this year 17 million. Actually, to date, we are running about 10 million. And by the end of the year, if we keep spending the way we're going, we'll be at $16 million in expenditures. That is 6% less than budgeted, 1% more than what we did in 2015, and 1% and 33% more than what we did in 2014. If we try to maintain the budget level we are at now at $17 million and look at our population in Alva at 5,174, that is, we need to be able to collect $275 per person per month to maintain the level we're at now. If we look within a 15-minute drive radius, that needs to be $199 per month. Currently, as far as our personnel is concerned, we've got 78 full-time employees, 39 part-time employees, for a total of 117 people on payroll today. We've budgeted for 78 full-time employees and 75 part-time employees. So we've budgeted for 153 people. We've got about an 8% turnover rate across the city. Cost per employee, for a full-time employee on average, total cost, benefits, everything, is $52,716 a year per employee. Part-time employees, total cost, $23,606 per year. If you combine that, we're running an average cost of $44,616 per year per employee. We budgeted for $4,689,944 for personnel expenditures, personnel-related expenditures. That's 27% of our total budget. We expect that we will spend $4,632,990, which is a little bit less than what was budgeted, but it'd still be 29% of our expected expenditures at the end of the year, right now. And I'm done already. That would be the highlights and everything.
I thought you ought to give him a hand. He's done early. Okay. So, what the format's going to be is about 27 people in this room. What I'm going to invite us to do is we're going to have four groups. And we'll number you off. Your supervisors, whoever you are, don't need to be in one group. So we want to have a varying group of participants in each group, no matter what your assignment or what your role is with the city, so that we can collaborate with ideas. So we'll have four groups, and out of each group, I'm going to invite you through this discussion is come up with at least three goals and or objectives within that this time frame, which is about a 30-minute time frame for discussion. And then in each group, get someone to record what you talked about, like somebody within your group, a scribe, and then someone to report to the group when we're done with that 30 minutes what your three, at least three, goals and objectives are, depending on the topic. We're going to write these on the flip chart. Out of all these four groups, we're going to pick the top three that you all agree upon, okay? And that will give Joe Don here a good bird's eye view of where you want to go and he needs to go to formulate goals and objectives for next fiscal year and determine a budget.
Economic development.
Okay. Economic development. On that particular subject matter, how are you working with the Chamber of Commerce? Any Chamber of Commerce people here?
Yes.
Okay. How are you working with the Chamber of Commerce? Do you have a plan to develop any retail businesses? How are you working with current retail businesses? Do you have, the City of Alva have a plan? Do you need more room to develop any type of businesses coming in? How can you maintain what you've already got, even through the oil and gas industry going a little bit on downturn here? So get out of the box thinking about what economic development means to you in the City of Alva, and discuss some goals and objectives on what you'd like to see happening with that. Okay? You got 30 minutes.
But you've got a point.
So, things to entice the city that
are we doing anything to
really in
All right, heard some great discussion, a lot of different topics. You went a lot of places from what I heard from your various groups. So, what I'd like now is group one, you would have a report on your top three goals concerning economic development. And Lisa's going to... Yeah, let's just have it by group, just list them here. And let's hear your top three.
In no particular order, number one, we have to establish funding sources for economic development. Number two, actually create incentive plans that Alex can go out for retail, for manufacturing jobs, wind energy, and also from outside entities or for our own local businesses that want to make improvements. We have to have a, you know, incentive plan to offer people. And then the third one was looking to acquire land or property that we can get to help with recruitment. Lease.
Okay, so we have funding sources, create incentive plans for local and outside resources, and acquire land. Okay, number two, group two.
We came up with provide incentives for the development of retail space, for betterment of retail space, better guidelines or criteria for the development or the expansion of our tourism events.
More better tourism.
More better tourism.
Really? I can speak that
language. More better. M-O. Wasn't there a company that had more better shirts?
Yeah.
Yep.
Have them come to Alva.
For what? I lost him at
the new slogan.
Maybe we could have, not saying that we've got bad collaboration, but better collaboration with county economic development entities and other economic development entities in the area.
Okay, collaboration with other entities in the area.
Spell it right with gear.
I don't know.
Use the Google.
Speak that, John.
Say it again.
County. With county and other economic development entities.
Okay. Collaboration with county and other economic development. And number two was more better.
Tourism. Guidelines and criteria for the tourism.
Committee. Tourism. Guidelines. Okay, number three.
We had, in no particular order, enhance our focus on advertising and promotions of what we do and do well in terms of
advertising and promotion.
But everything from, you know, making sure people are aware of the different opportunities in town with regard to the colleges, schools, healthcare, senior, retiree options and stuff like that.
Is that still number one?
Moving on.
That was a long one.
Yeah. It was.
Poor Lisa.
You catch all that?
Got it.
Enhanced focus on advertising and promotion. You good with that?
Good with it.
Okay.
Expand dining options for both with business incentives and worker training programs.
Okay. Expand dining options.
For employees, is that what you mean? Or what?
For the community.
Expand dining options for
community, including business incentives. With business incentives.
I heard employees is what I heard, but
with business incentives.
And number three is expand our tourism options.
Expand tourism options.
Yeah, I'm just trying to figure out.
Or enhance. Might be a better word.
Tourism. I'll do it. Options. I'll be like Kelly. That's the first one.
Okay, number four.
Okay. Some of the things that we came up with also was kind of similar to the other groups, you know, within the tax reductions or incentives for businesses, something that's going to bring economic development within the city of Alva. We also talked about tourism also, you know, what keeps people here in Alva, even if it was for a day, what's their options to do to go out and expand and view within the city of Alva. So that's kind of, we want that under tourism. How are we going to keep them people here to get that communication out, you know, to other towns and businesses from just them one day visitors. We also talked about our signage, beautification, and Wayfair signage projects that, you know, lead people to our business districts and around town, our arts districts, and allows them to know where they need to be going, where the hospital's at. And so we kind of put our and signage, Wayfair signage, and beautification, tourism, and incentive for businesses, tax reduction, make sure that we can give them their sewer, water options if they want to develop that land within the city of Alva.
Okay. You guys did a great job. I listened to all your discussion, and you went a lot of places, and I was actually encouraged to hear the dialogue. Okay, what we have here is a lot of commonality here. Tourism. We've got tourism here, tourism guidelines. We've got tourism here, guidelines. We've got expand tourism options here. Okay? Okay, so we have those three that are common. Okay, we have other commonality here in incentive plans. And down here, there was some other incentive plans as far as enhanced focus on promotions. And let's see, where else was that?
Number three was second, too.
I think each one of them has an incentive.
Yeah. So, here we go. Out of all of these, let's pick the top three that you want. We'll go down here again. Funding sources. We've got incentive all the way through here. Create incentive plans, local and outside. Acquire land. Out of those three, which one would you pick? We'll narrow this all down here.
Incentives.
Incentives?
I think incentives would be all inclusive.
Okay. Incentives right here. All right? Out of these three, which one would you like? Incentive retail. We've got incentives here already. Okay. Let's pick another one. Mobetta. Tourism guidelines and or collaborations with county and other economic development entities.
Collaboration.
Okay, out of the next three, enhance focus on advertising and promotions, expand dining options, community business incentives, and expand tourism. We've got tourism already up here. So out of these three, which ones do you want to pick? We have enhanced focus, advertising and promotion, expand dining options, community, business incentives. We've already talked about it, tourism.
But we didn't start tourism yet.
I thought we did.
Or expand tourism options, okay? But we have, yeah, we didn't start tourism, correct.
So I'd say tourism.
Tourism? Yes?
Yes.
Okay? Okay, the last three. Tax reductions, tourism, we've already talked about that, and signage, out of district, beautification.
Art district,
beautification. Out of those two.
Signage is already
signage?
By the way.
Everybody okay with signage?
But it goes beyond signage to beautification and other things, so I think there's opportunities beyond the signage.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, number three?
Wayfair signage.
Yeah. Number three.
Okay, we come up with four. I said three, but you okay with these four?
Well, I thought we were kind of picking three that were from all of that stuff.
Yeah, we are. One, two, three, four.
We've got four.
Okay.
So you want to keep these four, or you want to eliminate one of these?
Isn't tourism guidelines and expand tourism options? Could that not be considered?
That can be lumped in one deal.
Yeah.
Okay.
The second one is number three is the one to start.
Yeah.
Before we have our incentive plans,
that's true.
Collaborate with county development, and expand tourism and signage and beautification.
Yep.
Those are the four.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. You good with those four? Joe Don, got that? You'll take these with you. Okay.
Did you get that written down, Lisa?
Yep.
We got it right here.
Down right up there, boss.
I don't know.
What I don't have written down is my list of demands.
I'm sure we'll get to that.
Yeah, we'll get to that.
All right.
Incentive plans, better collaboration.
Okay, we got create incentive plans, local and outside, collaboration with county and economic entities, expand tourism options, signage, art district, and beautification.
Okay, got it.
All right. Okay, our next subject matter is personnel. City of Alva, and some things to discuss that come to my mind is, you know, do we need to look at skills? Does everybody have the skills they need to do their job? Does there need to be some training? Is this pay scale adequate? You know, he talked about, Joe Don talked about, you know, retention. You have a pretty good retention rate based on what he said, but you still have some attrition, you know, so maybe that's an item of discussion. Performance-based evaluations may be a subject of, you know, personnel evaluation. Benefits, you know, insurance, things of that nature. So just kind of, you know, get out of the box, talk about, you know, who works for you, how do they do their job, is there some training things that need to be done? I know that there's a facility here in town that does a great job in training, customer service, leadership, soft skills, that type of thing. Anybody know of a facility here in town that does that? No, it's not the top. Anyway, you know, talk about those issues and get some goals and objectives, and let's have about 20 minutes of discussion, and we'll come together again, three goals and objectives, and so let's get going. If I could have your attention. Group number four.
Yes, sir.
Hold down. Just a tad.
We're happy.
Okay. Number one, you guys ready?
Yep.
Okay, we're going to start with number two.
You didn't have to be guys ready.
I gave you a 5-minute warning.
Well,
okay.
Retired, training her. if we're starting here, the three things that we came up with as a group was the continual evaluation of our pay matrix and the implementation of the appropriate cost of living.
Somebody else here. Tattoo the chief over there.
We need to continue looking at our pay matrix, evaluating our pay matrix, and adjusting it. And adjusting it every year for this morning.
Continue looking at pay matrix and adjustment.
There you go.
All right. Number two.
We need to look at the advancement of our retirement program.
Advancement retirement program. Okay.
And implement employee recognition guidelines and programs.
Recognition guidelines.
And programs.
And programs. All right. Okay, everybody see those? All right.
No, he told me to write bigger. I'm following instructions for the first time in my life.
I believe it, too.
Do those stick to the wall?
Yes, they do. You want to... Are you the designated sticky?
I can do that.
Fantastic.
Until that, 10:30.
Get that first one off there, yeah.
Yeah.
There went the 10 minutes. Go down to the head table.
That's a big sticky. Okay. On top of that, put personnel in. Okay. All right. Group number four.
Let's see. Cross training in the departments in certain areas.
Cross train.
Interdepartment.
Yes.
What she said. Interdepartment. Okay.
And
number two,
department specific evaluations.
Okay, department specific evaluations. Okay, number three.
And can we have four?
Sure.
Okay.
Thank you.
More emergency personnel.
More emergency personnel. Folks, who works too.
Okay. More now. And see about insurance to pay full employee and family benefits for insurance.
Insurance benefits in full for family. All right. Okay, let's go with number three. Group number three.
We spent quite a bit of time talking about retirement, but then it also went into just a general conversation about wages and benefits.
So retirement / wages and benefits, correct? Correct?
Revamp the performance appraisal process.
Performance appraisal process.
And then the third one that we spent a lot of time talking about was ensuring the staff have in good repair equipment and tools needed to perform their duties. In good repair.
Anything?
No.
And personal attitude, we've done.
That has not been mentioned.
Okay. Staff has proper equipment. Proper good equipment.
That's a pretty good summary of our jumping around.
Okay. Group number one.
We had four, some of them, we had training, cross-training slash professional development. So if people wanted to learn other jobs, make sure that they have the opportunities.
Cross-training slash personal development.
PD, just the PD.
Okay.
We have the employee recognition.
Employee recognition, good.
We talked about why we don't have an employee of the month or something that we put out. Three was the salary cap.
Salary cap, okay.
And then one that kind of enveloped all of these were the communication from top to bottom and bottom to top about, which we think is improved and want to continue.
Okay, communication. When it comes to employee recognition, let's give Lisa a hand. Okay, out of those, I don't know if we want to write on those being on the wall.
Okay.
Probably not good. We get in trouble with that.
You were just a new paint job.
Wipe right off.
So, okay, out of this group right here, pick one. What do you think? Continual looking at pay matrix and adjustment, lack of advancement and retirement, employee recognition,
Guidelines of programs.
What's the number one right here? Can you guys see this?
Pay matrix.
What do we got here?
Pay matrix.
Pay matrix?
Yep.
Number one.
Okay, you can see that, right? See that little circle? Again, I don't want to write on the wall here. Have it bleed through. Okay, number two here. Cross-train, interdepartmental, department-specific evaluations, MOBETA, or just more, emergency folks, and insurance perks in full, including the family.
Can we pick two?
Insurance.
We all okay with insurance? I need to hear from you.
Yeah,
I have them, Would that be?
We have department-specific eval. We have insurance.
Would that be benefits in general? Insurance. I mean, when we talk about insurance, we've got more than just health. So would that be insurance and health insurance and dental insurance and
yes, the whole thing
and retirement?
Well, the problem. I mean,
whoever put this down, what do you mean by that?
Nancy,
I'm sorry.
Number four. Is that all inclusive, or
yes,
what is that?
There's look at different plans for
look
the insurance.
At plans.
Where maybe we offer X amount of dollars, and you can choose from these plans. Of, oh, I don't need vision insurance, but I can use this X amount of dollars towards my dental insurance and my health insurance. Or I don't need this insurance and this insurance, so I want to put it all towards this. And so you have more options in your insurance and different plans and different options.
And it's not just choose for us. Chose.
Okay.
Does that clarify that? What do y'all think? Cross-train, interdepartmental, department-specific evaluations, more emergency folks. We heard about the insurance. You want to pick two out of this group? Okay, yes, sir.
Can we just go through and say negotiated benefits or contract benefits? I mean, salary, health insurance, retirement policy. Because I think that's all four.
No, we can do that too.
So, if I'm hearing from you correct, insurance is a big deal here out of these listing of four. Is that the biggest one? You folks, what do you pick?
What do the employees say?
What do the employees say?
Ben says two.
Evaluation.
What does two say?
Ben says
department-specific evaluation.
Department-specific evaluation.
Maybe we got evaluations on another.
Yeah.
Say what? We'll circle two. And we'll circle
four.
You want to circle four?
Yes.
We'll come back to this and pick the top three.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
All right. Retirement, wages, and benefits. We already covered that. Somewhat with insurance. Somewhat. Performance, revamp, process. That would be, again, with performance. That would begin with evaluations, which is somewhat here, okay? And then staff has proper equipment in good repair.
That one.
That one.
I hear of that one.
Yeah.
All right. Again, we have cross-training PD.
Professional development. Sorry.
Okay. We have employee recognition, salary cap.
Is it good or is it not?
Okay, salary cap, good or not. And number four, communication.
Continue with.
Continuation, better communication. Cross-training, personal development comes with interdepartmental, in some cases, what we talked about. Employee recognition. Salary cap, good or not good, and communication. Now, is that communication, is that training, or is that just...
we talked about how that affects all of our top three.
Okay.
So really, we can take that.
Okay, so out of this group of four.
Salary cap.
Salary cap.
But wouldn't that be with the pay matrix?
Okay, so we got utility look at pay matrix and adjustment, the same as salary cap. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Then we have department-specific evaluation. That also is associated somewhat with salary, correct? Or not? Okay. And somebody said something over here. What was that?
Employee recognition.
Because recognition and evaluation can become a lump together.
Exactly. Okay. So, the top three. Let's continue looking at pay matrix and adjustment. Department specific evaluation. There was a lot of discussion on insurance.
You could easily, I mean, it'd be modifying ours a little bit, but easily put benefits in number one on the top one as far as pay matrix and benefits. You could easily lump that all together, basically. to where it kind of consolidate. Because it's all the same benefits towards the...
It's in the same package?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so we got benefits coming over here. Okay? Department-specific evaluation. So that depends on performance evaluations and those type of things. Whether you choose to be a part of an increase in pay or not. Okay, staff has proper equipment and repair. I think that stands on its own. And then we have employee recognition, which is somewhat related to pay, but not necessarily. And salary cap, that has to do with
pay matrix.
So, employee recognition. Now we'll just make a comment about employee recognition. I then had some training done, what's called as character first. There's been studies done with that type of training where employees will actually be have a better retention at a company if they are recognized publicly in a positive way. Statistics have proven that if you recognize an individual publicly for good character traits, they are less likely to leave that company than if you give them a pay raise. Because most people leave their job, not necessarily all, but most people leave their job, leave because of a conflict with the people they work with or their supervisor. Statistics have proven that. So, again, this may be a big deal. It's your call. So we got employee recognition, we have staff has proper equipment, and we have continue looking at pay matrix and adjustment, which goes along with the evaluation. Y'all good with that? Yes, no?
Say that again.
Okay, we got continue looking at pay matrix and adjustments, which includes benefits and insurance.
Could we also put in about the retirement, group that into that?
That falls under.
Yeah, that goes in about retirement and salary cap.
Okay.
Okay, we got department specific evals. Staff has proper equipment in good repair. Employee recognition. Kind of got four out of that.
Would employee be recognition be part of a evaluation revamp?
No. Not just in your eval, boss.
No, I understand.
Well,
I understand.
If the evaluations led to the selection of, I can see where he's going with it.
Yeah, I mean, it's not part of. I mean, it's not part of the recognition. It is under the same category as recognition, as the evaluation.
Because without the evaluation, how do you know what you need to recognize somebody for whenever you're recognizing?
You can't just say good job, Melvin.
Good job. But I mean, if you say good job every now and again, good job for what? What are you telling me good job for? I want to know what I did that was good.
But you have to wait a whole year to hear that?
No, but if you want to do the recognition.
Okay, bring this together. Bringing this together, your employee recognition can come at a monthly employee meeting, as an example. Or a council meeting where you recognize an employee publicly at the council. Just using that as an example. What was your comment, sir?
Well, just as you can see here, we have differences of opinions between employees on what they really want.
Sure.
I think one of the things that, I mean, as we're sitting here as a group trying to set priorities for 130 some employees, I think it's important that we get feedback from our employees on specifically what are the most important needs and concerns that they have before we make, you know, before we go forward with decisions. Because for some of them, it may be increased insurance. Some of them may not care anything about that. For some, closer to retirement, it may be the emphasis on improving retirement for someone who's 25, even though they should be thinking about it, they're not. So I think we've got to get a lot of feedback from our workforce to figure out what exactly are their priorities too, if we're going to create all of this goodwill and try to reward our employees for their performance.
Good perspective. So that's a future, that's future dialogue. Okay? Okay, are we good with this right now? Okay. We're going to move on. Okay. Next on our agenda is talks about our parks and building issues. So invite you to get together again and discuss your park situation. I'm not sure if that includes your ball fields or some of your other recreational venues. And then building issues, what specifically are you talking about there, Ron?
Problems we're having with our buildings.
Okay.
Maintenance, dilapidation, size, needs.
Okay.
Can you give an example for the group? I can give.
All right. 30 minutes.
Whether it's equipment at the cemetery, whether it's the roof of the library, whether it's the
Parks and buildings. Let's, everybody ready? You You guys want to go first over here, group four?
Sure.
All right, group four, here we go. Let's give them, give our attention to group four.
We need a new EMS fire building.
EMS and fire building, is that two separate buildings or is that combined?
They probably need to be together, but I know that some people want them separate. So I don't know. That's to me for the higher power to decide. That's just me saying it.
Okay. That's just you or the group?
The group.
Okay.
Sorry. I'm just speaking, but it's for the
okay.
group.
All right.
We need buildings for new street equipment we've purchased. We hate to have the new equipment
sitting outside.
Okay. Buildings for street equipment. Okay. Number three.
And rec center equipment.
No, I said the street sweepers sitting at the rec center.
Yeah. And then we need lighting and reconstruction of the ravine at Bud Rose Park.
Bud Rose Park lighting. And ravine. Okay.
And that's it.
Group three.
We had the need for a comprehensive building plan because a lot of our, whether it's public works, EMS, fire, police, their buildings aren't adequate from a capacity or condition standpoint. The next item we had was to reevaluate and revamp our approach to regular maintenance and upkeep. And then.
Upkeep what? Was that the end of the sentence?
Our property.
Oh, okay. That's
evaluate maintenance. And upkeep.
I do this all day long.
And you are so lucky.
Is that good there? Evaluate maintenance property?
Well, no, and it's our
property
maintenance. And I think what we focused around was assignments, responsibilities, processes.
Let's
I'm not speaking Spanish, Lisa.
It's so long. Can't you just condense all that before you
number three? Okay.
Let's just shorten that a little bit.
Process.
I said approach to property maintenance in the beginning. The approach.
Not meaning a ramp.
Approach to property maintenance.
Okay. It's all there. You figure that
you
out.
Good, you good with that?
Yes.
Okay. Number three.
Communication.
That's a problem.
Yes, obviously.
Communication regarding progress towards property issues
or status. Status and progress.
What's property?
To leadership, department leadership.
Communication regarding
progress reports?
Progress reports, yes. But there's not much progress, so there's not much communication. So it's communication in spite of that. Sure.
So what we're saying is we need to communicate towards the
department heads don't know necessarily what's going on with their building progress when there's not any progress. Seems to be what I'm hearing.
Okay, so what that means is we need communication towards property status, bottom line, right?
Yes. What I'm gathering the issue to be is when the budget is, or when there's, whether it's bid processes, whether it's budget issues, or whatever it is, when there aren't actions that are currently being taken, sometimes it feels like nothing is being done. So department heads want to know what is being done. I see this as a, from council to business manager out to the staff communication. Because some of that rests on us. A lot of that rests on us when it's decisions are yet to be made.
Is that clear?
No.
It's not clear.
Okay. Let's clarify that, and let's hold it there, because he said a lot. He said three mouthfuls there, if not more, and that's okay. It's all right. So let's clarify that, if we can. So we're talking about communication regarding buildings and property interdepartmentally. Is that correct?
We discussed not sharing equipment, that we need equipment to stay where it is. We need for it to be maintained and in working order. That's the maintaining of property.
Okay, keep in mind we're talking about, parks and building. Is that part of equipment?
Number two would have encompassed a, I don't know what the right, we didn't know what the right solution was. And then here's where,
start you, buddy.
Well, no, we didn't, because we said in some instances it's appropriate to have a roving crew. In some instances it's appropriate to have equipment on site at these properties.
Okay, keep in mind we're still talking about parks and buildings.
Maintenance equipment for the parks and buildings. Does the cemetery have what it needs on site, or should it be a, should the entire city properties have a roving crew to do that type of stuff?
Okay, that's another bullet point.
Well, so I was trying to sum that up in four words under number two.
So, let's look at this again. Okay, evaluate approach to maintenance, property, and equipment. Would that clarify that?
I'll let the rest of the group talk. I'm not doing a good job with this one.
Okay.
What about something like determine the best use of city maintenance assets?
That is what I was going for.
Okay.
That's what you're
city right maintenance at. Assets. That's number two.
Okay, say it again.
Determine the best use of city maintenance assets.
Okay, that's in relation to the parks and building, that's in relation to supporting the parks and building property, correct?
Yes.
Okay, all right. So we got number one, we got a number two, so let's complete number three here a little bit more clearly. So we have communication regarding interdepartmentally when it comes to determining how we're going to staff or park or equipment, or clarify that with me again.
Number three?
Yeah.
Essentially, that's that the staff want to be in the loop with what decisions are being made at the council and business manager level.
Towards their,
well, regarding their properties.
In a nutshell, and correct me if I'm wrong, but we have some long-term needs that need to be addressed, and we just need to develop a long-term plan to address those needs.
Well, that's number one.
Okay.
Okay. So.
Just let me, I think I can give an example of what Kelly's trying to say. I don't know how to phrase it. Let's say in our budget, we budgeted $100,000 for this project at the beginning of the year. So far, we haven't moved on that project for one reason or another. Have we communicated that fully to those people on why that hasn't been done? I mean, is that what kind of?
Right, yeah, you kind of, the department heads are left in the loop as to, okay, where are we at with this particular project, right?
That's what I was gathering.
And recently, we've started monthly meetings, and maybe those things will come to fruition through that action, whereas in the past, we've kind of felt out of the loop.
Okay, communication with council and department's head concerning building projects. Does that sum it up?
I think it probably is more Joe Don than council. Personally, I mean, he's the one that needs to communicate with the staff.
Okay. City manager communicating with staff concerning building projects.
And there was some, like when we were talking, there was a need for a clear chain of command and attention to detail in job assignments.
And I'd love that under him too.
Okay, city manager communicating with department heads concerning building projects. Does that make it clear enough?
With us
building projects. City manager communicating with department heads concerning building projects.
And I might reiterate upon that again. I think some of that's already been cured. It just hadn't been in place long enough for people to feel the, I think that'll take care of itself in time. We have a weekly Monday morning meeting, and Joe Don updates us, and we have an opportunity to ask questions. So I think maybe some of those sentiments are coming from things that, what's it, about 3 months now we've been doing that?
Not even 3 months.
Yeah. Yeah. So we're on the right track there.
Okay. Are we clear there on this?
Clear as
mud.
Yes.
Let's move on. All right. We got number one.
We keep it very simple. Bud Rose Park, number one. Two, which was similar plans basically for, we had fire EMS buildings, but overall plan for buildings.
Would you say fire?
Fire EMS
buildings. Plan for building.
Overall plan.
Yep. And then three, we put armory development.
Don't you like us so much better? We keep it simple.
Yes, I like ours.
All right. Route number two.
Yeah, I understand.
Keep it simple, Fred. Easy word. Easy word.
Does it begin with Mobetta?
Okay. Comprehensive maintenance plan.
Comprehensive maintenance plan. Okay.
Master plan for all parks and trails.
Comprehensive maintenance plan. Let's stick with that one first.
What did you say, maintenance plan?
Maintenance plan.
Maintenance plan.
Okay, number two.
Master plan for all parks and trails.
Master plan for all parks and
trails.
Okay. And three.
Evaluate the ownership of buildings. I'll let you catch up.
Evaluate ownership of buildings.
Buildings.
Okay.
That do not go towards city core functions.
City core functions.
Core functions, yeah.
All right. Now again, the topic was our parks and buildings. All right, let's just stay with that page right there. Okay. Out of the first three, what do you guys pick?
Two.
Fire EMS plan?
Yes.
Yes.
Do I hear resounding number two?
Yes.
Okay, circle number two then. All right, the last three, comprehensive maintenance plan, master plan for all parks and trails, and then evaluate ownership of all buildings that do not go towards city and core functions. Out of those three, what do you choose? What do you think is the hot topic there?
One.
We hear a one over here. We hear a one. One over here.
One.
One. And you heard it over there from one, so circle number one. Okay, flip the page back. Start at the top. We already circled EMS fire building, so we got that covered. Go ahead and circle one, because that's part of the other page. So we're good there. Street equipment / building. We want a building for street equipment. And three, Budrose Park, lighting, and ravine. So, two and three, what do we got there? Anybody? Hot topic two or three? Seeing none, let's move to the bottom. One, three, three, two. Okay, building plan, police, EMS approach. We kind of have that already to a certain extent. We just didn't add police to it. And we have number two, determine best use of city maintenance assets. And the number three.
We already have that.
So I can kind of had number two. But number three, we had the communication, city manager with department heads concerning building project and how that encompasses that total body of work. All right, what do you guys pick out of that? They pick number three over here from what I'm getting, right?
Well, which three?
Hasn't one and two already been?
Those are pretty much all.
We kind of talked about that, yeah.
Yeah.
We talked about one for sure.
We're already getting the first three. We just started that.
Okay.
So
you want to determine best use of city maintenance assets? You want to pick that one?
Do we have to pick one?
No, you don't have to pick it.
It looks like you're already covered.
You want to. You good with that? So what we're looking at then is EMS and fire.
I think to clarify, when you guys mentioned those, were those just the first two and then be an et cetera?
Yeah.
Okay.
Planning for all two, yeah.
Okay, we have fire EMS again and comprehensive maintenance plan. Y'all good with those?
Yes, sir.
All right. Let's tear them off and post them. We kind of got a little stalled up on this last session, but I do want to say something about.
We'll make it up over here in this
stuff. Yeah, I figured you would.
Yeah, fired Kelly. They fired me, but they didn't like the replacement.
I do want to say something about communication. And Kelly said a mouthful over here, and he was trying to communicate an issue. I find out in every situation that we deal with individuals is we all have communication issues. And it's a lot of times it's not clear. We didn't say it clearly, or we didn't receive the information clearly. When I was in manufacturing, a lot of times I had to dialogue with sales, engineering, management, you know, production, the whole thing. And when we figured out how to communicate clearly, you know, it solved a lot of problems. So I think the dialogue was great. I think we can learn quite a bit about our lack of communication skills. You know, sometimes we don't communicate clearly. So, and that's across the board. So anyhow, next discussion, and we're gonna kind of narrow the time frame here, is our public safety issues. And I'll just interject this. This last week I went to the National Tornado Summit in Oklahoma City. And even though I'm on the local emergency planning committee there in Major County, I'm also part of the safety portion of the Northwest Tech campus on safety. And I learned quite a bit about, we may not have a plan when it comes to tornadoes, fire. We think we have a plan. Do we communicate that clearly? Are we on board? But this is a little bit bigger deal when it comes to public safety. Do we have it together on communication when it comes to our public safety with the city of Alva? Whether it involves police, EMS, fire, and communicating that when it comes to the public involvement. Are we in line with Northwestern's, you know, communication? Are we in line with Northwest Tech? Are we totally in line with the city of Alva and communicating if there are safety issues? So let's do a 20-minute. Let's do a 15-minute discussion with that.
Well, if you assume a certain amount of liability, yeah, you do that. I don't think we wanted to assume that liability. In other words, are we ready to say that the library will be fire every time there's a storm? Yes. I know Joe Don and I have talked about the plan. We really can't add more sirens. We've increased our footprint of our city when we annex, but we can't add more sirens until we fix the problems we have with the ones we have being so antiquated, and they're on a phone line system. And I've actually sent a Joe Don as far as getting those transition from a phone line to a radio control. Once, it'd be very difficult to add a siren at another location right now. The system is so antiquated that there's not anyone in the phone company that even knows anything about those dedicated wires, how to get another one to another location. So if we can convert it, well, maybe just make the public aware.
Public education program to let them know what they need,
whether it exists or not.
Definitely don't want to minimize the importance of the safety issue, because that's really a big deal. Really is. So that being said, who wants to go first?
I'll go first. Over here. Okay, ready, Lisa?
I was born ready.
Okay. Tornado siren coverage and repair.
Tornado siren.
Ditto next to it. Somebody else
coverage.
Ditto that.
Chat.
I was agreeing with
in repair, what you're saying is they're broke?
Yes.
Some that have issues.
Okay. And they're always addressed, but they always resurface.
Okay.
Issues are...
All right. Number two.
Radio telemetry for the well field. Radio.
I know how to spell radio.
E-L-E period.
For the well-filled and automated...
Oil field?
Well-filled.
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 / automated well fields.
You would really be under.
Okay, in other words, radio communication, is that what I hear?
Correct.
Okay, number three.
Number three, repair dilapidated water mains. Repairs, or replace.
Repair old water.
Replace, not repair, sorry.
All right, who wants to go next?
We'll go.
Okay, here we go.
Without repeating anything they did, public education on severe weather preparedness.
Public education. Weather preparedness. Okay, two.
Staff safety committee.
Staff? Is that what you said?
Yes, yeah. Staff safety committee is what you're saying. Okay?
I'm led to believe it exists and hasn't met in 3 years.
Okay?
No, we met.
Three.
Staff, not council. It's already been said.
We got her done. Okay.
Wow, you get A plus.
Go right over here. Group number one.
One is a couple of questions, I mean, do we have disaster emergency plans in place?
Yes.
We do? Does everybody know it then?
I think that falls back to our public education that we.
Is public and our employees stuff as well?
Okay, could we word that staff and public communication?
Does that plan address recovery? That's what we're saying. Does everybody understand their jobs citywide if a disaster happened, on any kind of disaster?
And that's where you're going to fall.
Don't we have a contract
your
with
ICS system and your LEPC meetings where we do plan for them issues?
What about people besides emergency responders, though?
Tech is involved in that. The schools are involved in that.
We get all that, but we're saying like just our downtown city employees that they're when they get calls all the time about stuff, are they educated? Do they know what to do?
Well, that's where we're going to revert back to their supervisors because they're really going to be the boots on the ground or their single resource avenue.
Clarify, downtown. Who are you talking about?
The city hall?
City hall.
So like if
or even the different departments, if they were hit, do they know where they go? If we're like, for example, we get hit by the tornado, where do they go within the next couple hours to help with the situation or what is their job?
I'll apologize for being brief, but our conversation was such that that was too brief, I guess, this time. But it was a matter of we understand that our emergency responders have good plans and know what to do in these situations. We don't have a good way, or we have not demonstrated a good way of communicating with our public how our city responds and recovers from such incidents.
Okay, communicate so, public safety evacuation. Does that cover it?
And do we have redundancy in our responders by chance that a responder happens to be part of the...
As much as possible, yes. As much as possible. I mean, there's a certain point there where, I mean, we're going to be relying on mutual aid from other cities that have not, hopefully, have not been suffering from the same event. It just depends on how...
I think we're probably similar to the other ones then. The only other one we talked about was a communication protocol of do we have one specific person that's going to speak and then put like a public information person? And then do we also have, I guess part of that was just even for us on certain things with public safety, do council members, and when we talked about our protocols of what we need to know, when we need to know it, how we're going to receive it, so we just kind of...
Okay, communication protocols covers all that.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Anything else?
Not that really hadn't been said then.
Okay. Over here, group number two.
This may have all been said. Communication officer.
Mm-hmm.
Upgrade communication system. an emergency communication plan.
What was number two, boss?
Upgrade communication system. And the third is emergency communication plan.
Emergency communication plan.
Okay, emergency communication plan.
Well, it looks like we have a commonality here of communication, communication, communication. So what we're talking about is communicating protocols with our emergency plan and upgrading the communication system. So basically all of that applies, would you not agree? Concerning communicating our emergency evacuation plan and our system. Okay, let's flip back over. Okay? Everybody agree that we need to do a tornado siren coverage and repair? Is that a priority?
Yes.
Circle it. Okay, what about radio communication out on the well? Imagine that's the water well.
Yes. Yeah.
In, okay. Is that a priority?
Yeah. It's not a priority until we're out of water, and then it becomes a big
and I'm sure it'll be what brought up. We can bring that up again later underwater, too.
Yeah.
Okay. Repair old water mains or replace?
Underwater too.
We have a water issue. Okay, public education preparedness that comes along with communication.
Yes.
On the next page. All right, and staff safety committee. You say you have one, but it's non-functional.
Correct.
Is that important? Yes. No.
Yes. The last work that they did was the development of a traffic plan that most of the recommendations weren't implemented.
So do we feel?
Actually, it wasn't the safety committee that did it. Did that work?
Not council.
No. It wasn't no. It wasn't the safety committee that did the work on the traffic plan.
Yeah, we were.
Not as that committee.
Well, put that group back together, whatever group that was.
Yeah. I think it's important.
Everybody?
Well, or just say that's important. The findings of that.
I hear that's important.
Yeah.
Correct?
I don't think it's necessarily important who did it, right, but that it's done.
Okay. So let's put a circle around that one. So we have tornado siren coverage and repair. We have staff, safety committee. However you want to put that together, let's flip the page. And basically you can circle that whole page as communication within your protocols, your system, and your emergency plan. Mm-hmm. We good with that?
Yep. Yes.
You got three there. All right? Okay, I think you've all did a super job this morning. You've communicated candidly with openness and respect, and I think you did a good job. Let's give ourselves a hand here. I think y'all did a good job. Sanitation issues are the next topic on the agenda. So last time we took about 15, 20 minutes to discuss that topic. Is that plenty of time for you?
More than enough.
Feel like that's plenty of time?
I can talk trash to anybody in 10 minutes.
I didn't think it would take that long.
That made me choke on the chip.
Okay.
There you.
It's 20,
I dare you.
20 after 12. So let's take 15 minutes. You need a little more, we'll give it to you. But let's talk about that. Again, come with three goals and or objectives in that
in that framework of sanitation issues.
We want to throw these out there. Now it's a good service. It's also something that I know at times helps our community look a little more trash than it is.
I think one thing that's going to help that though is if they get transferred out, you've got somebody helping.
So is our policy, should it be delivered to the transfer station? I really think we should get away from it. I'm not trying to.
We do have a roll-off box out there, 15 electronics.
We've got one for electronics, one for appliances like metal appliances, and then of course there's the limb pile and the grass pile.
And then we've got one for construction.
Is that the pallets?
The pallets, I've got a guy that'll come once we get 300, he'll come pick them up.
Okay, if I could have your attention.
Yes.
Let's start with group one over here again, and if you could list your three objectives.
Well, we put the one, maybe a public education of our transfer station and what can be done and what can be taken there. And
technical difficulties.
Okay, could you repeat that again?
Public information / transfer station.
Okay.
We've heard some conversations already, so we're just going to go ahead and get these out here. We can talk about them. But one, we just talked about recycling, about what we can do, whether it's at the transfer station or partnerships or whatever.
Recycle. Okay.
And then we talked, and I understand what Benny was talking about, and hopefully the number one goes, but you always hear public perception about having more cleanup days for the, you know, an emphasis of cleanup days and all of it.
Okay, cleanup days. Okay, group number two.
Well, we touched on the recycling, exploring more opportunities for recycling. Second one was provide weekend opportunities to dispose of items, household items, trash. I mean, you can only dump right now from 8 to 5 on Monday, Friday, but if you had a place on the weekends where you could do that.
So does that go along with the cleanup days that
it could help.
They mentioned?
That could help with it,
yeah. All right.
Yeah, I think we'd like to see this though on a consistent basis, or one weekend a month or something.
Okay.
Like that.
Very good.
And the third would be to enforce / strengthen our ordinances on property
upkeep. Okay.
We talked about that as well as. If you did that, you wouldn't have to worry about the cleanup days.
Okay.
So.
Actually, you're right, but again, that's another category of enforcement when property owners don't take care of their property.
Yeah.
And they don't mow the grass and don't trim the, you know, and the house runs down and all that other stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Group number three.
We're number four.
Three.
We're behind
you.
Add to that.
Air curtain
incinerator for refuse.
Hey, that was us.
We were supposed to
have
that.
You
should
have
went first.
You had what?
Air curtain incinerator.
Air curtain?
Yeah.
Air curtain. Does everybody know what that means?
No.
Can you explain what that is?
Incinerator.
Yes.
Air curtain incinerator.
It is a equipment and method by which you can burn at very high temperature refuse.
Okay.
It would.
And it conforms with EPA standards for burns.
How much does that cost? That's yet to be determined. Okay. Number two.
We're good.
You're good on that one?
Rest of our
turn. All right, now.
Hot dog roast too, couldn't
it? Number four.
Well, we're not going to repeat anything else that hasn't already been said.
Sort of.
But one thing that we didn't have was new dumpsters and packer trucks for sanitation to haul to the landfills.
New dumpster and?
Dumpsters.
New dumpsters.
Okay.
And?
Packer trucks.
Packer trucks. Okay.
You're welcome.
Okay, let's flip the page back for a minute.
It's our trash.
Okay. Out of the first three, what do you think is the most important there?
Have you seen their office?
It is the dumpster.
Number one?
I like the public education.
Public education.
Get rid of.
Okay. Everybody okay with that?
Yeah. I like to clean
it. Right. Circle number one.
Go ahead and circle number three, too, because I think cleanup days would help point out.
Well, would that not fall under the second one, provide a weekend dumping?
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's true.
If I were to make a suggestion, cleanup days and weekend dumping and all of that kind of falls into what do we do with big trash?
Yeah.
Okay. So you want to categorize the cleanup, the weekend dumping, and enforce the ordinances of property cleanup kind of in one category? Because it's all relative, correct?
And I think through public education, you're going to probably start eliminating some of those problems by that.
Okay. So we got three, two, and three there that's kind of in a category that would, in other words, build on each for that whole process. Would you agree?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you have those suggestions there that you can lump in. All right, let's turn the page. Okay, out of that.
I think Benny likes one and two.
The air curve would be the most important idea. Yeah.
Okay, number one, but circle one.
The new dumpsters causes public perception, though, because if you've got anybody seeing these beat up, rusted out, no offense, trashy dumpsters.
Pun intended.
How long does it take a new one to look like that?
Okay, we have the list, and we have three goals there already mentioned. So let's just leave that alone. You have that information, but those are your top three. Your air curtain, come back to it. And then your public education and transfer station. Then you have all your categories that refer to cleanup and weekend dumping, and then the ordinance of making sure that property gets cleaned up. Y'all good with that? All right, let's move on to the next category. Which is the street alley issues.
Up with ordinances on the site,
Okay, the street and alley issues, let's do this. The 15 to 20 minute discussion concerning
streets,
that topic.
I'd rather go crack seal everything and not let the weeds grow.
Is there
chipping seal?
Dig it up
6 days later, yeah. Because we got
water burns. But
that's what we don't know. They're doing it. I don't expect it.
The water line you just put in, and I can't think of. These aren't labeled which. Is that water lines or streets? What's red and blue? You know,
these are
capital improvement projects.
Street water.
Could be either.
Okay. Streets and alley issues.
You forgot.
Oh, yeah, gotta do that. Alright, let's start. Here, come a little bit later, you'll really be clapping. Here we go. Let's start with group two here. On this go around.
Keep following our existing plan for street repairs and maintenance. Keep doing what we're doing.
So you have a plan already?
Yes, we do.
Okay. Follow existing plan. Okay. Any others?
Increase public education as to what the plan is and where we're working.
Okay. Now I saw you had a map or a graph.
Yeah.
Is that available to everybody?
Everybody should have a copy of it.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
It was part of the packet.
Okay. And number three?
Do some alley resurfacing with material that we take off streets that's no longer usable on streets or something. Use that in the alleys to strengthen the alleys and reduce the, try to start working to reduce dirt runoff out of alleys that come down the streets.
Okay, alley resurfacing. All right, how about number three? Group three.
It's worth repeating, but stay the course. Keep following our existing plan. We talked about the intersection at 281 South and Shear Drive. And we talked about the possibilities for a hot mix plant to serve our community region. Three, yes.
Okay.
Hot mix plant. Okay, group one.
All pretty similar on the street plan. We just talked about maybe there needed to be a reevaluation as well, just to see if some things, if some streets have worsened, maybe it needs to change. And then we put also look into infrastructure grants.
Okay, reevaluation of plan.
Reevaluation of plan? Mm-hmm.
The street plan, I mean, just make sure.
I thought I heard you say something else, I'm sorry.
No.
And then number two was looking for grants.
To help with the infrastructure.
To help with infrastructure, okay.
And the third one was basically somebody already said.
Okay. All right.
Group four.
A lot of it's been said, so I'm just gonna put out there we were different in. You know, the hot asphalt, we think that the street department needs the proper trailers to transport that asphalt when we get into that part of the plan that asphalt's coming down, or hot asphalt to transfer it back from Woodward or Enid, wherever we're buying it. We think that public education, I know it was said, but to be a little bit more transparent to the public, to let them know that these are street repairs and not street replacement. And we understand that this is on our city's website, but maybe hit other avenues like social media, things to be more transparent to the public so we get the correct information out and not the incorrect.
Does City of Alva have a Facebook page?
Yes.
Okay. So in other words, communication to the public on street repair, correct?
Yeah.
That communication keeps coming up. Okay, let's
let's go back to page one. And keep following existing plan. That seems to be very prominent in agreement. Everybody okay with that? So let's go circle number one. Increase public education. That goes along with what some of you have said already about communicating to the public. You all okay with that? Mm-hmm. All right, you okay?
Yes.
Okay, number two, let's circle that. Is alley resurfacing the third goal you want to highlight?
I'd like to highlight number two on the second list.
Okay, we're not there yet, though.
Oh, I thought you said, okay, hold on.
No alley resurfacing yet. Basically, stay the course. We're already there. 281 South and Share Drive.
Share 281.
It is the roughest entrance. Intersection in this town, especially if you've got somebody in the back of an ambulance. Like, there's no way to take that, even just braking over it and trying to slow it down as much as you can. You're still going to shake the patient in the back of that ambulance.
Put a star by it.
I love
it. Okay.
And that could be one where that just that's part of the plan.
Exactly. Could do that.
It doesn't have to stand alone.
Okay. Hot mix plant.
I think we could sell it to a lot of neighboring communities. Counties, I don't know, the state has trouble, I think, at times when they start going into Northwoods County and Alfalfa County and stuff like that. I don't.
Well, what's the possibility of having somebody like Venture come set one up for 2 months? I mean, there's.
I've even had people talk to me about building one for us.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, that'd be.
So, but I think we. I'd want us to explore what possibilities we'd have if we.
Well, that's what I was wondering. I mean, if you own it. Going to sit not being used a lot of the year, but if you lease one from a company or have them come set it up and run it for you.
I don't know enough about it.
I don't either. I keep looking at Ben.
Let's go to the next page right now.
It's a lot of money.
Okay, yeah. Reevaluate the street plan. Would that go along with number one? Mm-hmm. Think so? Okay, looking for grants. Is that even a possibility as far as, is there grants available for city and municipality street repair?
Yeah. I have not found it for streets. I found it for other things which could open up money for streets.
Yeah. Okay, so let's put a star by that for now. Okay. Proper transport of hot asphalt. Wouldn't need that unless if you had the hot mix plant, well, you'd have to have at least something there. Public ed, street repair, hot replacement, not replacement. That goes along with communication about what you're doing already. And communication to public. We already talked about that. So, number three. Grants, or let's go back to the other one, back to the page. Hot mix plant, is that hand in hand? What are we thinking?
Yeah, if there's a grant for it that we could look at to help facilitate that or cooperation agreement between the counties or neighboring counties and city. I mean, I think it's an avenue that you could at least look into and explore.
Well, the county was looking at putting a plant down there at Aylward at one time. I don't know if that all fell through.
I guess exploring, I don't think I've got an issue with exploring the possibility of the advantages of having one or the disadvantages of having one, or what we could be gained from it. I don't know that, from what I understand, I don't know that we have the ability to operate at current times, the ability to operate a true hot mix plant, funding-wise, to buy it and staff it, and everything else that would require. I mean, I think you're looking at least five extra people?
I think between that, between whether it's a plant or whether it's the transportation,
it's a need.
Solution for meeting our hot mix needs.
Okay, let's turn the page. Back again, so keep in mind the hot mix or looking into proper transportation of hot mix. Is that item number, that's your item number three? Keeping in mind, looking for grants also might be part of that. You're always agreeable.
I mean, if we buy, let me ask this question. If we buy Woodward, any of the hot mix or whatever, and they deliver it to us, what's the advantages for us to own a hot mix trailer?
Do they deliver it or you go get it?
We go get it.
I thought they were delivering. That's
answer. Okay, so are you all in agreement of transportation of hot mix, proper equipment? Are we in agreement with that? Do I hear a yes?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Circle that one. Number one. All right. So we have three goals. And then a star beside the looking for grants for infrastructure. Okay, I'm going to ask a question. You want to take a break or you want to move on?
Let's go.
Okay, let's take 15, 20 minutes and talk about water, wastewater issues.
If that water leak had some fucking capabilities to go through.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
I know my neighbor, their water meter is on my property.
Okay. If I can have your attention, let's give our attention to the group who's going to report. Let's start here with group two.
Three. We need
three.
To.
That's number one.
I'm thinking I've only got three.
Oh, gotcha.
I've got.
Sorry, boss.
Yeah, that was my inside voice, not my outside voice.
The inside voice is slipping out.
We need to look at the well field and the needs there to include revitalizing our current wells and add a telemetry system, rework our telemetry system. We need to have continued evaluation and repair of
our...
Is
this number two?
Yes, this is number two. I'm sorry, am I going too fast?
Yes.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Continue?
Which one?
Number two, say it again.
Okay, continue the evaluation of our distribution system, both water and wastewater.
Distribution, is that the way?
Yes. Both water and wastewater. And as the opportunity presents itself, move our water lines from in the street to the easements.
Yeah.
Okay, you want to finish number one?
Yes.
Well, you have well field revitalization and what else?
To include reconstruction of wells and
telemetry
system.
Okay, we good with that? Number one, group one.
Oh, yeah, the two that we had one that was very similar, other two were looking for future water rights.
Okay, future water rights.
And then establish a funding source that would help basically with all of this.
Funding source for
water infrastructure, water.
Okay.
Are you just talking about drinking potable water, non-wastewater?
Yeah, we're on the
well, the funding would be putting aside money every year to prepare for purchase of water rights when that time arose, or for the implement, you know,
new main line to town.
Okay. Constant maintenance of the lines that we've got, instead of having to worry about when we have a $300,000 water line that needs to be replaced. Okay.
Funding source for future water.
Right.
Improvements.
Okay. Okay. Is that it? Okay. Group three.
We are also concerned about future water availability.
Okay, so we already have that.
And just to add on to that, quality water. In addition to capacity. And then
let me just clarify that. Are you talking about a water treatment system?
Or, well, I hope not.
Or a water, as it comes out of the ground, a better quality?
Regionally, our neighbors experience problems with water quality that necessitates water treatment. So if we can mitigate the need for that, or if we can find another source, but I think if we put all our eggs in the capacity basket, we might miss the mark on quality.
Okay.
That's all I'm saying.
Nothing like Flint, Michigan, right?
Right. I know the government will help us out, so.
Okay. All right, water quality, is that all you got?
And then the only other one we had was continue addressing the water wastewater line system, which was on the other page.
Okay.
Let's move here.
Have materials available on site to fix any breaks for dilapidated water mains or sewer. And upgrade.
Hold on.
Oh.
Materials on site to fix main breaks.
As they happen?
Yes.
Okay.
And upgrade sewer lift stations.
Upgrade sewer lift stations.
And that's all I have.
That's all you got? Okay.
The rest of they have been said.
Okay. All right, let's flip back to page one. All right. Well, field revitalization and telemetry. Continue evaluation of distribution, both water and wastewater. Move water lines to easements as we can. Okay. Out of those three, what is the most important?
Telemetry.
Number one. We good on number one?
I don't know enough to. Is that
that's
top
what Russell
on your
says.
List?
What, uh-huh. Can you tell us what this is for us that
that's
don't?
That's our move. Rebuild some of the wells and because there's like, what is it, like 10 wells that aren't
not using.
Producing. So just revitalization of the well field, which without some of the sources. I mean, it was also mentioned too, like permits are a source, but that's part of telemetry.
The telemetry actually runs the water wells. It tells you to turn on, tells them when the tank's full, tells us everything, so we don't have to be down there all the time. We just, what we need is a little bit, a couple more antennas down there in a few places. We already have telemetry, we just need upgrade.
So, crucial to the water supply of Alva?
Yes.
Okay, everybody good with that as a priority? Okay, circle number one. Okay, continue. Equal, is that equal or evaluation?
Evaluation of distribution.
Distribution of water and waste and, or move water lines to easements as can out of those two. Any of that a priority? Hearing no discussion, how about future water rights?
I think that's something that needs to be considered. I mean, you're always going to be looking at water rights.
Is that synonymous with, I mean, obviously it's synonymous with future water sources. I mean, water rights.
Same thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what we would.
Okay. So let's combine one and two as number two there at the bottom. That's it right there. You okay with that as another priority? Those two? Circle one and two together. So you've got the second priority. Okay, let's move to the next page. Okay, we have water quality, materials on site to fix water breaks as they happen, and upgrade sewer lift station.
I think we go back and just whichever one it said, water and sewer line
plan. Distribution.
Repair, replacement, distribution system. That, to me, lumps the rest of it together the way it needs to be.
Okay, turn back the page then. So you're referring to?
To continue to evaluate distribution of water and wastewater lines.
And to include repair and replacement.
Okay, right on number two to include repair and replacement. Which would also include moving to easements as well as out of the street, correct? So you kind of lump two and three together. Okay, let's circle those as number three priority. You good with that?
Yeah.
No? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Any other priorities there that you want to just highlight? Okay, book it. Okay, well, she's putting them on walls. We have down here as any other issues that you as representatives of the city of Alva need to discuss. Have we covered everything you want to cover today?
There's been an overriding theme of communication, and I think we need to figure out how as a city we're going to communicate better with our citizens.
You know, it's a good point because, you know, we've mentioned it a lot about communication and how we communicate one-on-one and how we communicate corporately and as a group and as a community. You know, and I think every community has those issues and an opportunity to improve. So that's a good point. And that was mentioned just quite often about our communication and our communication skills. So how should you go about addressing that?
Starts here in this room.
Okay. Starts with me. Starts with me. Everybody can point it at me or yourself. Okay.
I think there should be some designated responsibilities within the city management of who's responsible for communication and those messages that are going out.
Does the city of Alva have any conflict of relations?
The city manager is the PIO officer according to ordinance.
Okay, designate. You know, we can look at this. You know, things usually come from the top down, not from the bottom up, for the most part. Every position that I've been in usually starts at the top and rolls downhill. Very seldom does anything roll uphill. It does sometimes. But all of us in this building are community leaders. Would you agree to that? Okay. So with that being said, here's something that was really pointed out to me not too long ago at we invited a Chamber of Commerce director from another facility to come talk to our chamber board at Fairview. And one thing he said is you need to support each other. Now you may not all agree on everything, but the main thing is you support each other. So when we're looking around this room, Joe Don over here, he's at the top of the food chain right now. You got the mayor, he's at the top of the food chain. If you talk bad about him, either he's in public, or you say something that would be not a positive slant, or something that would be a negative slant, what reflection does that have on you as a community and how you communicate with each other? I've had to evaluate myself when I'm going, wow, I really need to support my administration where I work, which is Dr. Gerald Harris, which I do. It's a great boss. But you know, I have a staff that I need to support as well. All the daytime instructors, our custodial staff, and how I communicate within our group about them. Do I communicate on a positive note? Or do I communicate on a note that's less than admirable? So what I invite you to do is, in this communication issue, all of us here are responsible in our own way to communicate in a positive way. Would you agree with that?
Yes.
Do y'all agree with that?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I see most of your heads nodding. In fact, I see all of your heads nodding. So, really, when we come to this issue right here, it's all of us. It's all of us supporting the city council, your supervisors that are on all of your crews and department heads, your mayor, your city manager, because if you disparage him in public or in private, that does not shed a positive light. And that goes with any town, any company, any manufacturing company, oil and gas company, that reflects on you as a person, on you as a company. So what I'd invite you to do is really look at how we communicate, you know, with each other and about each other. You know, it's been said, those who gossip to you, gossip of you. And how we communicate with each other also is an indication how we communicate with somebody else. And I don't want to sound critical in that manner. And I don't not pointing fingers. I don't know really any of you at all. But I say that with an unbiased opinion because I've had to deal with that myself. Something that I have to work on. And it's an everyday process. So I invite you to really look at that. And when it comes to designated,
needs to do it. We all ought to be standing up. I need to do it. I need to do it first. Okay. Any other points of discussion?
Just want to thank you, Steve, for spending your day with us. I want to thank everybody that's here. I understand that I haven't been outside, but I understand it's beautiful out and you guys spent most of your day here to work on this. I think this was an important first step for creating what hopefully will be a common goal and set of goals for our community. And part of being able to communicate is having the information that you need in order to be able to do so. And I think we come out of here today with the same information having been presented to all of us. And so it's I think we're going to do some good things. I appreciate you all again. Those of us that sit on the council, we can't make good decisions without you guys doing, good jobs in each one of your departments, and we do appreciate you for what you do every day. Don't often get a chance to thank you, and I'm sure we don't say it enough, but thank you guys for what you do. Thank you for spending your Saturday out here, even if Joe Don did make you.
Now,
I
heard you start with roll call earlier. Did I hear a motion for adjournment?
Yes.
A second.
I don't know that that's necessary, but we're done.
Give your all a hand.